How can I persuade you to do what I want using only my thumb?
I think of a couple of possibilities.
Yes.
No, I've got nothing that isn't filled.
Nothing.
Nothing that isn't filled.
It's known as the thumb of power. And it's a hand gesture used very widely by modern politicians when they make speeches.
Oh, it's to stop you doing this, isn't it? To stop you going...
Yeah.
But you.
Apparently it's more powerful. Don't do that because people don't like you, but if you do that, you look like you're a powerful person. Yeah.
Never do that as a politician.
No. There's a science of oratorical hand gestures, and it's called charonomia, and it was set out in precise detail in 95 AD, so a really long time ago, Quintilian's Institutio Oratoria. It says here, one of the commonest of all the gestures consists in placing the middle finger against the thumb and extending the remaining three. It is suitable in the statement of fact, but in that case, the hand must be moved with firmness and a little further forward, while, if we're reproaching or refuting our adversary, the same movement may be employed with some vehemence and energy, since such passages permit of greater freedom of expression. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you guys this.
Yes.
I think Paulie Walnuts and The Sopranos.
Does he?
And Spider-Man.
But the study of oratory and rhetoric dates back a really long time, and there's all sorts of rules about classic rhetoric based around the rule of three, which is the same as in comedy. So, Tricolon, I came, I saw, I conquered, or Veni, Vidi, Visa, I came, I saw, I shopped. Molossus, so that's three stressed syllables, yes, we can. And Epizeuxis, so location, 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 when you repeat the same word over and over again. But it hasn't changed, it hasn't changed. So you get ethos, logos, and pathos. Those are the three modes of persuasion. So ethos is how you establish the credibility of the speaker. So watch QI, I'm on it. Logos, you present the logical argument, watch QI, it's really good. And pathos, appeal to the emotions, watch QI, or we shoot this kitten. I'm just using it as a rough example. There have been manuals about how you gesture since there have been speeches. This is a wonderful one.
Well, I've done this on a stag do. Zorn football, it's called. It's a right laugh. 12 of you, boom, boom. We didn't dress like that.
Bob, dob, do. Bob, dob, do. Bob, dob, do. Ow.
I think he might be learning the Macarena. Sure.
And politicians can't help but use them. My favourite example is Richard Nixon. On the day that he was made to resign as president, that's what he chose to do as he left. He clearly hadn't got the message in. It hadn't gone all that well.
I think I could play a young Nixon.
Yes, actually, that's slightly terrifying, isn't
it?
And Angela Merkel always held her hands like that. In fact, in Germany, it's known as the Merkel Router, the Merkel Diamond. That's just how she always holds her hands. And Trump also, lots of signature hand signals.
When Donald Trump took to office, little did he know.
Angela Merkel's one. It's like she's going to go open the door, see all the people.
It does. So perhaps the steeper, and then, oh, look. Oh, there's no British people. But don't you think, Victoria, when you have your photograph taken, it's awkward to know what to do with your hands, isn't it? If you're a woman, especially, you can't sort of put your hands in your pockets, can you?
No, yes, terrible. I've read things that say, you know, if you put one foot forward, you look thinner.
I like the idea of the one foot forward.
Just do that. Always just do that.
Why is that?
Because people will always remember you.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.